everyone, I'm Harry, welcome to my channel, and today we're going to look at the light pedal from Gamechanger Audio. So before we get started, if you like this demo video at any point, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the little bell notification for me as well. It really does help me out a lot, and that way you won't miss out on any of my future uploads. There's going to be affiliate links down in the description to every piece of gear I used in this video and to record my videos. These do help support the channel out further, so I'd really appreciate if you go and check them out. So the light pedal is actually a Spring Reverb, but of course, being Gamechanger, they always do things really differently and unique, both in the way that the tones are produced and some of the options you can get to get some really unique tones. So the light pedal combines all the best features of a classic Spring Reverb with an innovative optical sensor system and powerful effect section that opens up countless new types of reverb textures and sounds. It actually uses infrared optical sensors to harvest the full tone and harmonic range of a Spring Reverb tank. To capture the full range of the Spring's movements, the light pedal uses multiple sets of special infrared optical sensors that act as photoelectronic pickups, which are able to detect much finer movements than the output transducer, which is usually used the Spring Reverb systems, resulting in longer decays as well as much wider frequency response. So we have a bunch of different controls on the front of the pedal. So the spring output is controlled by the spring knob. Adjust the spring drip with the drive knob and the output signals tone with the tone knob. We actually have three different level controls. We have one for the dry signal, one for the spring signal for traditional Spring Reverb tones, and one for the optical signal. The tone control affects both the spring signal and the optical signal whilst leaving the dry signal as is. When using the sweep or trem optical modes, you can either use the optical signal on its own or combine it with the spring tank's output for a multi-layered effect. The drive control determines the amount of signal being sent into the spring tank in all modes. Maxed out, the spring tank will gently break into distortion as well as affecting the textures of all optical signals. Gate is a global parameter that affects both reverb outputs and all effect modes. 12 o'clock is neutral. To the left, all reverb is gated. So the louder you play, the more reverb you get, and reverb stops as soon as you stop playing. And to the right, all the reverb sounds are ducked. So no reverb when you're playing and then reintroduced when you stop playing. And then of course, we have a six-way selector switch for the different effects modes. The first three are optical effects, whereas the last three occur within the spring tank itself. So the optics modes lets you choose a specific set of optical sensors, and you can use the control knob to select different pairs of the sensors. The sweep mode is a modulation mode that rhythmically scrolls back and forth through different sensor pairs. Control adjusts the rate of the sweep and use control while holding down the fit switch to adjust sweep modulation curves. The trem mode is an optical tremolo mode that turns the optical sensors off and on rhythmically. Control knob actually adjusts the tremolo rate, and you can hold down the fit switch and adjust the control to calibrate the optical sensor pairs. Tremolo can also be applied to the spring tank output if the spring output level is set equal to or higher than the optical output level. So now we're getting into the more spring tank effects. So the reflect mode is a lo-fi delay mode that will send signal back into the reverb tank multiple times. Control adjusts the delay rate, and control while holding down the foot switch calibrates the optical sensor pairs. The feedback mode sets the spring tank into self-oscillation for drawings and wall sound type distorted reverb pads, which is great to use with an expression pedal or with the pedal in momentary modes. Control adjusts feedback frequency, and control and the foot switch together calibrates the optical sensor pairs. And then finally, we have the harmonic mode. In this mode, the spring tank is driven by a special circuit designed to produce a lot of overtones and harmonics, giving you shimmer type reverb tones but produced naturally in the spring tank. Control adjusts the shimmer effect central frequency, and control while holding down the foot switch calibrates the optical sensor pairs. In any mode, you can make the control knob value react to the instrument's input signal by turning the gate knob while holding down the foot switch. You can also combine the effect modes, any three of the three optical modes, with any three of the three tank modes. We have a switch for tails and a switch for latch or normal switching, and then we have a switch for latch that allows you to switch between normal switching or momentary for the foot switch. There's also a shock sensor built into the pedal, and on the back you can either have it as off, soft or hard, which will turn off the wet signal if the pedal gets knocked hard. So some of the other pieces of gear I'm using my 1958 Reissue ES335 with Monty's 54 Humbucker side P90 pickups. The amp I'm running into is my Hamstead Artist 64 RT, which is one of my favorite clean pedal platform amps. Then that's running into a Celestion G12M 65 Creamback speaker that's being recorded by a Lewitt MTP440 dynamic microphone, which is like an SM57 with a tiny bit more bass. So let's get straight into the demo. We'll be right back. So there we have it. That was a look at the light pedal from Gamechanger Audio. A really unique way of doing reverb and actually using infrared optical sensors to pick up the full frequency range of the springs. Of course, you've got three different level controllers, one for the dry signal, one for the normal spring signal, and one for the optical signal, as well as loads of different effect modes so you can get some really different textures and sounds from the reverb itself. We have the three optical effects and the three spring effects. We have a time control that acts on only the reverb sounds. Then that really cool gate or ducking feature as well. We've got a latching fit switch, or you can turn that off if you want. But I'm into refit switching. We've got trails. And of course, we've got the shock sensor on the back of the pedal, so you're not getting a crashing sound when the pedal's engaged or if you kick it really hard. Gamechanger always make the effort to make really unique effects and ways to do certain effects. And this is exactly what they've done with the light pedal. You can get those classic spring effects, but with all the different ways of getting that reverb, you can get some really interesting and unique reverb times as well. But let me know down in the comments what you thought of the light pedal by Gamechanger Audio, and if you go and pick one up for yourself. Again, there's going to be affiliate links down in the description to every piece of gear I used in this video and to record my videos. These do help support the channel out further, so I really appreciate if you go and check them out. If you did like this demo video, please leave a like, comment and subscribe, and hit the little bell notification for me as well. It really does help me out a lot, and that way you won't miss out on any of my future uploads. Other than that, go onto my channel, check out some of my playlists. I have plenty more lessons, covers, gear demos, had soundlight videos, and anything guitar related. As always, I've been Harry, and thanks for watching.